Good afternoon, all of you. Today I am going to present my research on influence of relative positioning of tufts on mechanical properties of thin woven fiber composites. Space missions need various space structures. They require energy for propulsion, but feasible and renewable energy there is solar energy. So these structures should be large in surface area. These large structures have to be built on Earth and then sent to space. These three figures on top are currently in space, and the bottom two figures shows future missions. So now let's get an idea on relative size. This is 160 by 160 meter solar sail which has to be stored within this part of this shuttle. And the solar sail is nearly a half of our lotus tower. So, as I mentioned earlier, storage of this large space structures is the major issue here. Then, the introduction of deployable structures solved that problem. Earlier, mechanical hinges were used at the folding edges, but they were too heavy and complex to operate. Then, self-deployable structures replaced mechanical actuators, where they can store energy while folding, and by using that stored energy, they can deploy themselves. And this figure shows a solar sail with self-deployable carbon fiber reinforced polymer booms, which are made of woven fiber composites. Woven fiber composites are used in aerospace applications due to their self-deploying nature, high strength to weight ratio, and high damage tolerances. But before going into details, it's very important to understand the basic constituents of woven fiber composite. These are called tows, which are a bundle of fibers combined using resin, and these are called plies, which are a tow arrangement in a particular order. But accurate prediction of mechanical behavior is crucial for the success of the project. For example, an antenna structure containing three deployable booms was sent to Mars orbit, but it failed to deploy after reaching the destination. So, understanding the behavior beforehand is very important. But conducting a physical experiment would be highly expensive and time-consuming. So, several methods have been followed in order to predict the mechanical properties of woven fiber composites. Classical lamination theory is one of them. It is a commonly used predictive tool, and it predicted the in-plane properties of woven fiber composites with good accuracy, but the out-of-plane properties are over-predicted. That is because of some assumptions of CLT, such as uniform distribution of fiber and resin, it assumes constant tau thickness, and it doesn't account for the tau waviness, and also it depends on the number of plies, and CLT is not suitable for single to two ply woven fiber composites. On the other hand, numerical modeling techniques are used for the accurate prediction of mechanical properties of woven fiber composites using their advanced computational methods and easy adoption of required properties. Regarding the numerical modeling, a folding hinge simulation and a physical photograph are shown here. An element in this boom is modeled as a homogenized shell element, where we need representative unit cell approach in order to come up with the mechanical properties. And by considering the repetitive nature of woven fiber composite, a suitable representative unit cell is selected. And then the material properties of combined fiber and resin and the geometric properties which are obtained from micrograph are imposed into this RUC model and then analyzed. But a deviation in bending stiffness with experiment results was observed earlier, and there's a significant variation in mechanical properties between the extreme fiber configurations, and the intermediate cases of the fiber configurations are not studied yet. So I am trying to examine the effect of relative positioning of tows in this study, with an objective is to investigate the effect of relative positioning of tows in 2-ply plane wave carbon fiber reinforced polymer laminates on prediction of homogenized mechanical properties. And these two figures shows the extreme fiber configurations. First one is fiber in phase arrangement, where the phase difference between top and bottom ply is 0 degrees. And second one is fiber out of phase arrangement, where the phase difference is 180 degrees. So, modeling tows and their interactions. So, earlier, several studies considered various key parameters, such as tau path and tau cross section, where rectangular tau cross section with a trapezoidal tau path, sine wave, fourth root of sine curve are there, and the cubic Bezier spline curve with an elliptical cross section predicted the bending properties well. And another consideration is interconnection between taus. So earlier multipoint constraints were used at the tau crossover points, but it resists the relative movement between taus. And then surface-based cohesive constraints were applied in order to allow small sliding between tau surfaces, and also it gave a good prediction. And then fiber configuration, as I mentioned earlier, these are the two extreme fiber configurations, and it has found that these two cases yield the upper and lower bound for the experiment results for the bending stiffness. And there were some parametric studies have also been considered in order to find out the effect of geometric properties on mechanical behavior. And another parametric study to find out the influence of material properties on mechanical behavior. So in our study, the finite element preprocessor called TextGen was used to generate the representative unit cell, and the tau path was idealized as a cubic Bezier spline curve with an elliptical cross section having a power of 0.5. And then these models are exported to Abacus finite element software. Then surface-based cohesive interaction has been applied in tau contact surface areas. And then a set of boundary nodes were connected to a separate referent points, which are located at the mid-depth of RUC, as you see in this figure. And those are connected using multipoint constraints. And periodic boundary conditions, these were applied to representative unit cell in order to replicate the continuum nature of woven fiber composite using equation constraints by connecting a pair of reference points at the opposite boundaries of the RUC with respect to the respective dummy nodes. And the formulation of ABD stiffness matrix, the constitutive relationship between static and kinematic variables results in ABD stiffness matrix. And here, virtual work principle has been considered, and external work done by the given unit deformation is equalized to the internal work done by the boundary nodes, and which results in ABD stiffness matrix. And considering one unit deformation at a time, six separate analyses for each of these deformation have been considered, and which results in one ABD stiffness matrix. And the ABD stiffness matrix entries are shown here with explanation. And these are the three different relative positions considered in this study. One is 0 degrees phase difference, 90 degrees phase difference, and 180 degrees phase difference in X and Y directions. And regarding the results, a significant variation in axial stiffness has been observed here, and it shows an increase at 90 degrees. And regarding the shear stiffness variation, which is minimal along with phase difference, and a slight increase at 90 degrees has been observed. And if you consider the bending stiffness variation, if we move from 0 to 90 degrees, it shows a reduction, and if we move further, it's increasing. And then torsional stiffness variation is shown here, and it's increasing with the increasing phase difference. And the maximum deviation of the stiffness values with respect to the in-phase model are tabulated here as a percentage. And the significant percentage of variation in extensional stiffness and torsional stiffness has been observed, and a small variation in bending and shear stiffness has been observed. The influence of relative positioning of taus on mechanical properties of two-ply plane wave carbon fiber reinforced polymer laminate was studied numerically, and more realistic tau geometries were generated using TextGen. And this research concludes that relative positioning of taus have significant influence on axial and torsional stiffness, and there's a minor effect on bending stiffness, and the phase difference shows a negligible effect on shear stiffness. And for the future studies, it is recommended to consider the intermediate phase difference cases and also phase shift in one direction, and further development on modeling tau interface characteristics can be done. And these are the references. Thank you.